let's get into some of the other theories, because this is a difficult thing to process. And this is a group of people who have designed their entire life around not having to process difficult things. So they're not great at it. But according to Ben Collins, there are conspiracy theories. Some can't believe the president wouldn't support the same storming of the Capitol they believe he explicitly called for. So they're saying the video is a deep fake, or he's being threatened by the deep state. Something deep is going on. Deep crows, I don't know. But it's either not actually him in the video, or he's being threatened by the deep state, which again, based on your worldview, that is not an answer. Because you believe he's been maneuvering behind the scenes for 4 years with JFK Jr. and all these other, and Gandalf, and they're gonna take down the deep state. What, he can just be threatened into submission? That doesn't fit in with the whole Q thing at all. But the idea that it is just a deep fake, that it's not actually him, that like that is a classic diversion tactic. We didn't actually lose. It's not actually him in the video. Hillary Clinton is actually already arrested. They thought RBG died 3 years ago. Everything's whatever it needs to be.
Right. What, and then you have to just ask yourself, what is the point for them? What did they think the point of it is? And for a lot of them, I think it's just a sense of community. There was something amazing that was happening on that I saw on Reddit today. It's like one of those posts from, I don't know if you can see it. It's got like the,
I can't see it.
Anyways, it's got a, it's, this is someone on, I think it's 4chan or, I don't know, 4chan. Saying, imagine spending the better part of the last 5 years having your brain and ego melted by uninterrupted slash poll exposure. Flying to Washington in the middle of a pandemic to hear Trump whine about Oprah and Mike Pence at a rally. Marching up to Congress on his orders to smash stuff and then mill around aimlessly. You go home and hear that Biden won already, and all of your favorite Twitter news sources named like Patriot Newsman of the West with avatars of Roman statues have posted your photo online and are labeling you a quote gay communist Antifa actor. Because a lot of them have, but based on what you're saying, they're like, well, there's gotta be an explanation. Let's look at all the people in the crowd. Oh, that's a gay communist Antifa agitator. But that's not, we all know that's not. No one would do that. It's just the only people crazy enough to do something like that by QAnon conspiracy theory, hook, line, and sinker. And they're there and they're gonna see themselves on these sites. Being pointed out as the by Fox News, which is fine because now Fox News is on the other side. That's a big enough entity to throw under the bus. But now the Patriot Newsman of America is also calling you a gay communist Antifa agitator. Then the next day, the God Emperor you pasted into Warhammer memes puts out a video cucking himself and bending the knee. I'm sorry, those were heinous acts. Papa, please let me back on Twitter again, Jack. You can't leave DC because the airlines have dubbed you a flight risk, because the flight attendant union is trying to get them to stop, to not be able to fly home. You can't stay because the cops are actively looking for you after one of their own died. Your roommate at the only hotel that would accept you is a guy named Based Kekistani 1488 who wants to show you his Goblin Slayer torrents. The sun is going down. And you're getting cold. This is one of the best pieces of political writing I've seen in a while.
It's better than Twilight.
Almost better than Twilight. You obviously have only watched the Twilight movies. Because you have, if you read it, you realize it gets.
I didn't read it or watch it. I watched True Blood though, it's basically the same thing, right?
I've been rewatching True Blood a little bit.
Anyway, I might actually, at least the first season or two.
It's really good.
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.